Grace. We thank you for the privilege of being in the body of Christ. We have come together to watch this miracle take place, your love and your power through the Holy Spirit and the lives of these two people. The power of God and the Holy Spirit will honor this day through these two people and the congregation that are here as witnesses. We thank you, Father, for blessing this union in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. All right. As I read this scripture from the fifth chapter of the book of Ephesians, write this down, some of you may need this. I want you to pay close attention to what God says about the marriage. Remember, when we're born, it's maybe two people, or maybe it's one, or maybe nurses or midwives that bring the baby into the world. But it takes a village to raise all of us. Mothers, fathers, sisters, brothers, aunts, auntie, adoption. Everyone, it takes a village. And we thank you all that you are a village. Married people, you are here to make sure this couple stay married. Not get in their business, but give them love, give them peace. Call to say, how you doing? We praying for you. Let's go to lunch. Bond with them. Because that is why you are here. Amen. Why? Submit yourself unto your husband, Damon. For this is the Lord's will. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church. And Christ is the Savior, so he is your Savior. Therefore, as the church is subject to Christ, let wife, Taylor, be subject to her own husband in everything. Damian, husband, love your wife as Christ loves the church and has given himself for it. For this is the sanctity and the cleansing and the washing of water, that you may present yourself to the church. She is your church. He is your church. You are the family. Your church is at home. Without spot or wrinkle, and not having anything but God, seeking him first as your advice from the Bible. So are men to love their wife as their own body. For no man ever hates his own body, but cherish it and nourish it forever. For we are members of the body of Christ, the flesh and bones of our bones and flesh of our flesh. For this cause, a man shall leave his father and mother and shall join unto his wife, and these two shall be one. Damian Jamaica Bradford, have you accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior? Your response?
Yes.
Taylor Ann Washington. I think that's the last time I'll be saying all their names. Have you accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior?
Yes.
All right. So to the bride and groom, in the beginning, let's talk about the beginning. When Adam was made by God, and God recognized Adam as being his son. And Adam named all the animals two by two, but he looked around and saw, hey, I don't have anybody. Lord, send me somebody. I don't want to be alone. Everyone is two by two. So God took the rib from Adam and made him a woe man to be by his side, not to be under his feet, to be by his side, to stand next to him and be superior in everything that they do. This marriage is some serious business. It is a holy union unto God beyond reproach. Let no one interfere. So I speak to my guests today. Guest? Family?
Yes.
All right. I just want to make sure you were there. All right. Jesus said in the 18th chapter of Matthew, again I say unto you, that if two of you agree on anything, it shall be done. God agrees with us all. But sometimes we may not agree with each other. And that's okay. We can put it back for another day. Yes?
That's right.
All right. So regarding the union, the audience, you are here to witness. It takes a village to make sure marriages stay together. And we want you to honor that. That's why you're here. You have their cell phones. You have their texts. You know where they live. Send them words of cheer. Give them encouragement. Don't get in their business. Give them encouragement.
Yes.
And the audience will agree and say, we will.
Yeah.
All right, that's what I'm talking about. So bride and groom, from this point on, from this minute on, repeat after me. My door to the past has disappeared. I think you need to say that a little louder. Damien, you must work together in unison. Work through your challenges and your discrepancies. Do you both understand? Your response will be
yes.
All right. You know I'm such a teacher, right? Damien, Jamaica Bradford, do you take Taylor Ann Washington to be your wife as your flesh, to love her even as Christ loves the church, to protect her all the days of your life?
Yes.
Then turn to her and say, I, Damien Jamaica Bradford,
I, Damien Jamaica Bradford,
according to the word of God,
according to the word of God,
I join myself to you.
To be your
husband. From this moment forward, we shall be one.
All right.
Taylor Ann Washington, do you take Damien Jamaica Bradford to be your husband, submitting yourself to him only and unto the Lord, showing reverence to him as the head of this union for the rest of your life? Okay, then turn to him and say, I, Taylor Ann Washington, according to the word of God, submit myself to you, to be a wife to you. From this moment forward, we two shall be one. All right.
Thank you.
rebuke any negativity that may try to come in and cast this union out. Because where two or more agree, it will be so. And amen, we'll follow. A ring is a precious thing. It's a token of your faith and love. This ring is made from precious metals because it does not break. We don't break each other. We encourage each other. We love each other. And when we need help, we call for that lifeline. Wear it always as a symbol of your love to each other. Damian, place this ring on her. All of them. Now say after me. With this ring, I place on your finger as a token of my love, and I release it now in the name of Jesus.
Step by step.
Y'all know my mama must be in the house.
That's it.
That's all you need to say. Everybody know in the name. In the name of Jesus.
All right. To the groom, Damian. A ring can mean two different things. It's a never-ending circle sign of your love, but not a shackle. I am going to charge you with a memory that you will always say. The woman stands by your side, not under your feet. You have the responsibility of being in this union and a spiritual responsibility to God. Remember, she is your helpmate, and never shackle her with dominance, but always remember your faith and love to her. Taylor and Washington, I want you to place this ring on Damian's finger. There is no place in the Word of God that gives people the right to dominate each other. Your vows have stated to submit to one another the responsibilities of life, expecting God and His power to always make the difference. So place this ring on his finger, and I want you to say, with this ring I thee wed. I give it as a token of my faith. I believe with all my heart that this is forever. It is my love, my faith to you, in Jesus' name. All right.
Can I kiss the
bride? Not yet. As a representative of the state of California. And Almighty God, before God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, I now pronounce you husband and wife, but don't kiss yet. You got to take communion. We will now have the ushers, Deacon Spencer, Deacon Lee, and yes. So we're going to talk about the communion and what it means. It means that if you have received Jesus as your Lord and Savior, and you believe he died on the cross for you, then you are saved. So those of you and the audience that has accepted Jesus, you can repeat after me. I have accepted Jesus as my Lord and Savior.
I have accepted Jesus as my Lord and Savior.
I believe he died on the cross for my sins.
I believe he died on the cross for my sins.
And he was raised from the dead.
For my sins,
my sicknesses,
and my diseases.
And from this day forward, I will speak to him as my Lord and Savior. You are now saved. Everyone can take the communion that wish to. It's not a denomination. It's not a Baptist or a Catholic. It's God. And so the ushers will pass if you want to take the communion, and then I will give them to Damian and Taylor. Right now I want Mr. Bradford to come and take communion, and I want Aunt Sandra to come and take communion.
Thank you.
give them announcements. This is 1 Corinthians 11th chapter, and it talks about taking communion as often as you do this. This is bone of Jesus and flesh of his body. The blood never loses its power. Anytime you feel you're in an argument, maybe you got COVID and you want God to save you, you take communion. Some people just only do it once a month. I do it every day to do this service. I've done it 30 days.
Calabasas in the backyard. So wherever you have it, do it.
Do it. I don't care how old they are. Do it. Open your hand, Damien.
Yes, Lord.
Taylor, open your hand.
Beautiful.
Two are one. I anoint my grandbaby, Daylon, Emery, Bradford, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Yes, Lord.
Oil. I'm mixing this oil with you. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, we give this baby back to you, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Bless her all the days of her life. Educate her, keep her safe from all hurt, harm, and danger. In the name of Jesus, protect her, Lord, to and from her destination. We claim health and healing to all of her flesh, all the days of her life. She is blessed in the city and blessed in the field. The fruit of her body, the fruit of her womb, her mind is blessed. We rebuke all types of vaccinations, things that they try to give to kids. She will be immune from that. When we give her back to the Lord, because the Lord gave her to us. She chose these parents here. She chose Damien and Taylor to be her mother and father. Children choose you, and it's up to you as this gift to nurture them in the way of the Lord, to educate them, to leave them an inheritance, to stay by their side. To stay by their side.
Yes. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. Her nickname to me will be Versailles. Royalty. She is a queen of the nation. This is why we're wearing gold. She's royalty. She looking. Look at her. Her eyes is open. She ain't crying. She know what's happening. She looking at those angels. All right. Thank everybody. We're going to break down the room. You're going to have hors d'oeuvres and things at the bottom. We're going to take pictures. And then you're going to come back and the room will be transformed for dining. The bride and groom have requested for you not to give them speeches today, but save it for tomorrow. Eleanor is standing here in red. No more. No holding hands to look at the rings. So tomorrow, Eleanor will give you my address. Everybody's invited to my house at 12 o'clock noon. We have entertainment, food, and you can roast them all you want tomorrow, okay? No, we have a full bar, full food, and full entertainment, and you